How many peppers could a woodchuck cut if a woodchuck could cut peppers? I'm guessing a lot. Have you seen their little tiny hands? And they got them daggers on there? God, it's like Edward Scissorhands. Look at the oils. Look at the oils. I hope you guys can see that good. Oh my lord. It's glistening. All right, everybody, welcome back. And look what I got. The orange gator zigzag. At least that's how we set it down at Van Dyke's greenhouse.
The orange gator zigzag.
But Di's a great lady, and she gifted me this pepper. Thank you, Di. I have cut it open, okay, to show you guys the oils. There is a cut in the video, but by no means do I plan on harvesting any seeds out of the orange gator zigzag. If I wanted this pepper, Di is such a great lady, I would just go down and talk to her and she'd help me out or give me some plants for next year, or next year get some plants. So I just wanted to show you guys the oils inside the pepper. Amazing looking pod, so gnarly looking. I love how it goes from that orange to a red transition. And it almost has a black tip to it. The one I ate yesterday had a black tip, very prominent black tip. And that's gotta be a sure sign of danger.
I'm in danger.
I think Ralph is one of the most underrated Simpsons characters of all time. He's got some great bits. But you know, when we tried this down at Van Dyke's greenhouse, we only did a little bit of it, and it lit me up pretty good. And I gotta say, the one I ate yesterday lit me up pretty good. It was like scorched earth on the tongue. So we are gonna eat this right now, bye. I am nervous. It almost reminds me of, is it John Mellencamp? Hurts So Good, that song. Come on, baby, make it hurt so good. Sometimes peppers make it feel like it should hurt so good. I don't know. But yeah, this is gonna hurt so good. Cheers, everybody. Orange gator zigzag. Let's go. That's a great flavor for a pepper. It's hot, really hot. Ooh, had me stumble for a sec there. I got good heat all over the, it's so weird, even down there, I got a massive roof of the mouth burn. Same thing. It seems like the burn went right to the roof of the mouth. Roof of the mouth, all at the back of the tongue. My heat for that would be, God, good 3 or 4. 3 or 4. Flavor is really good. Again, another great pepper for a hot sauce. I find all Di's peppers, I don't know how she's doing it, but you're getting great flavor peppers with amazing heat, like scorching heat, scorching earth heat. She lights you up, like that lit my, it engulfed the whole back of my tongue, roof of the mouth. Wow, yeah, seems like the heat's climbing there. 3 or 4 for my heat, maybe rising to the upper echelons of a 4. Great pepper though. I will say, you know, I did the pepper yesterday, ate one yesterday, and I had a little bit of camera trouble, so couldn't upload it. But eating this one today, it's the same thing. It's great burn. It's got me like clammy. I think I'm clamming up a bit here. I can still talk and function. And you know, one thing with, I think we were down there 2 weeks ago at Di's, And when we did the whole pepper tasting thing a couple of weeks ago now, it's got my head itchy. I think my head is itchy. Eyes are watering a bit. But I think my nose is starting to run a little bit too. But I was worried to do that one yesterday, and then I had exposure issues with the camera. Everything was so bright, and I didn't have everything set up right. But I think my tolerance is growing, guys. It's that movie, like Raising Cain. I think it's raising tolerances around here, because I do believe my tolerance is rising from eating all the peppers down there, eating the prima tali, you know, a week ago there, and now to eating these peppers. I have eaten other pods too. We eaten the white scorpion. I also ate some off camera as well, different pods here and there. So I do believe my tolerance is being elevated, and it's as simple as that, right? For raising your tolerance, as quickly as it can fall, it can also rise again. I will say that is building up saliva in my mouth though, like, whoo.
Got my eyes watering too.
But also I think with the tolerance being raised a bit, I still don't believe that is as hot as the prima tali that we got from Dai. When we were down at Dai's greenhouse there, I thought this was maybe a bit hotter, but now, like, I'm not hiccuping or nothing, right? So, but that prima tali lit me up good, son. Like, that was a hot pepper, very hot. And it kind of rattled me a bit, the prima tali, but
I think that golden prima tali from Dai this year is hotter than what I had last year.
I think I'm doing this one pretty good, handling this one pretty good. So I will say the golden prima tali was way hotter than, well, not way hotter, but I mean, it was hot. You know, this one's still really hot too. But yeah, great pepper though. Great pepper, great burn. Most of them, I will stand by my statement to what I said down there, and I think a few of us have said it down there. That would be a great a pepper for any pepper eating competition, because it kind of has me mumbling, stuttering, and everything else going on here. But it's an eliminator. That will take you out of a competition. If you were to put two or three of them on a plate, man, whew, a little sweaty. Eyes are running, guys. Eyes are running. Ooh, yeah. Maybe my tolerance isn't rising. God dang. But yeah, no, it's, I feel like it is being elevated, and it's as simple as that, guys, right? To raise your tolerance, you know, just enjoy the burn. You don't gotta go all crazy, and gradually, day by day by day, you know, your tolerance is gonna be elevated. And before you know it, you'll be eating pods and having watery eyes in no time. So there's that, right? But yeah, so I just want to reiterate again that by no means do I plan on harvesting any of them seeds. I know it was... There was some cuts in the video there, but I promise, and you have my word, Dai, that, you know, I have the utmost respect for Dai Van Dyke and Van Dyke's greenhouse down there, and I will not be growing any Orange Gator Zigzags next year, although that is a great pepper and I would love to, but I will not. I don't have any more seeds. I have nothing. I have no more peppers. All the peppers are gone. And if I, you know, I do want to grow it, but if I do want to grow it, maybe I'll go see Dai next year and get some plants. I want to see her about getting some prima tali plants as well. I'm just rambling on here, but I will say I think my burn has kind of leveled off a bit now, maybe down to a 2. You know, I think the prima tali had more of a lasting heat too. Like, it was, you were just at, like, you know, at that steady burn for a while, where this one's kind of, it has kind of faded down a little bit now. It's kind of backed off. I feel like I can talk again. So there's that. That was the Orange Gator Zigzag. Guys, if you're ever in the Woodstock area, go check out Van Dyke's greenhouse. Great people over there, great pods, great peppers, great plants. She also gave Olivia this big basket of flowers and pretty cool stuff, right? Like, Di's a great lady, and I just want to say again, Di, thank you for everything this year and for the pods. So that's going to do it for me, guys. Cheers, everybody.